Hello everyone, in this video we have one triangle. Here is 4x, here is 2x, here is given x, and then these two sides are given equal and x is asked. Okay. First of all, if we separate angle 4x as 3x and x, like this, and then let's call here k, and if we connect K and C point like this, notice that there is the same length opposite of the angles X, right? That means A, B, C, K is a cyclic quadrilateral, right? Okay. And then if there's a 3X opposite of the length AK, here angle ACK must be equal 3x because of cyclic quadrilateral. And we know that two interior angles equals one exterior angles, so here must be equal 6x, therefore 3x left here, right? Okay. If you focus on ABK triangle, this triangle is an isosceles triangle. Therefore, BK must be equal AK, right? I want to represent with circle sign these two equal sides. And then if you focus on triangle ACK and triangle BKD, these two triangles are congruent, right? Because they have two equal sides and angles which between these two equal sides. So, according to side angle side, these two triangles are congruent. And then we know that congruent triangles have same side and angles. Therefore, if there is a this side opposite of the angle X, so opposite of the angle X must be equal same side, right? That means triangle CKD is an isosceles triangle. So here must be equal 3x. And then if you focus on the biggest triangle, we know that sum of the interior angles equals 180 degrees. Therefore, 4x plus 2x plus x plus 3x must be equal 180 degrees. So 10x equal 180 degrees. That means x equal 18 degrees, right? Okay, so that was the first method. Now we will calculate value of x using second method. These were given equal and angle ACD equal 6x, right? And then let's call these equal sides A unit. And here I want to represent with B. If you focus on this triangle, if we apply sine rule, A over sine here, angle ADB, we know that sines of the supplementary angles are equal. That means we can calculate sine 7x instead of sine angle BDA, equal B over sine 6x, right? That means A over B equal sine 7x over sine 6x. Okay, this is the first equation. And then if you focus on biggest triangle, let's apply one more sine rule. A over sine 3x must be equal B over sine 4x. Right? So A over B equal sine 3x over sine 4x, right? Okay. This is the second equation. And then if we equalize first and second equation, therefore sine 7x over sine 6x must be equal sine 3x over sine 4x. And then sine 7x times sine 4x equals sine 6x times sine 3x. Did you remember how we can calculate this kind of equation? Let's remind you, sine x times sine y equal minus 1/2 times in parentheses cosine x plus y minus cosine x minus y. Okay, this is very important. And then if we apply this property for the question, 1/2 times cosine 7x plus 4x minus cosine 7x minus 4x equal minus 1/2 times cosine 6x plus 3x minus cosine 6x minus 3x, right? So these are again, and then notice that these two expressions are equal, that means these are also again. Therefore, cosine 11x must be equal cosine 9x, right? Okay. That means we have two scenarios. Let's remind you, if cosine A equal cosine B, first scenario, A must be equal B plus 2k pi, k is an integer. And second scenario, A must be equal minus B plus 2k pi. Of course, k is an integer. Okay, this is very important. And then, if we apply this property for the question, first scenario, 11x equal 9x plus 2k pi, k is an integer. That means 2x equal 2k pi, so x equal k times pi, right? Therefore, value of x can be equal 0, 180 degrees, 360 degrees, and multiples. But if you focus on triangle ABD, let's call here theta, we know that sum of the interior angles equals 180 degrees. That means 4x plus 3x plus theta equal 180 degrees. So 7x equal 180 minus theta, that means x equal 180 over 7 minus theta over 7. So x equal 25.75 minus theta, right? Notice that x must be smaller than 26 degrees. Therefore, x cannot take these values, right? And second scenarios, 11x must be equal minus 9x plus 2k pi. K is an integer. So 20x equal 2k pi, that means x equal k pi over 10. So we know that pi equal 180 degrees. That means x equal 18k, right? That means x can be equal 18, 36, 56, and multiples. But we know that x must be smaller than 26. So these are again, that means x is going to be 18 degrees. Thanks for watching. And if you want more videos like this, please subscribe my channel. Bye.